This month we're continuing our look at altered tunings and looking at the tuning dadgad, so called because the notes it contains are D, A, D, G, A, D, from low to high. And here are those tuning notes. To demonstrate the point that you don't need to use the lowest note as your key center, I've created an arrangement of the traditional American tune, The Water is Wide, in the key of C major. Exploring different keys in any tuning is an interesting and satisfying way of understanding the scrambled logic of that tuning. Here's the tune, hope you enjoy it. See you next month.
Hi, this is Richard Stuckerite with this month's Classical Guitar. This article looks at the flamenco falsettas. These are the melodic themes that are played between the rhythmic compasses. The ones played here are falsettas in the Solearis form and can be inserted between the compasses introduced in last month's article to make a flamenco solo. Hope you enjoy playing through the music. See you soon. Thank you.
Hello, Eric Roche here again with the last, for the time being at least, in our series of classical duets. This month we're looking at the first guitar part of one of Ferdinando Carulli's compositions. It's taken from the second duet in his Opus 34 collection and is a popular concert piece, having been performed in the past by John Williams and Julian Bream, among others. I'm to be heard in the right channel playing guitar part 1, which appears in the Unplugged column this month. Guitar part 2, played by Phil Hilborn, will appear next month. As with last month's Bach piece, both parts are very interdependent, so pay careful attention to the dynamics and to the rhythms. Here's the piece in full. Hope you enjoy it. See you next month.
Lee Hodgson here with this month's main transcription, Wonderful Tonight, by Eric Clapton. What can I say except enjoy this classic love ballad? So check out our version of the tune, followed by the two backing tracks. The first of which is minus the doubled lead guitar. The second is minus the rhythm guitars. See you soon. Lee Hodgson signing off.
Hi, Eric here. This month we're looking at the much-requested Bronnie Hour by Jimmy Page. The tune is based on an open C6 tuning. Here are the open strings from low to high. The tune is not too difficult, although you should take care with the left-hand fingerings. Keep the requests coming in, and I'll see you next month.
Hi, Dave here with the bit that most of you have been waiting for, the guitar solo. On the following track, I improvised a solo using as many blues cliches as I could think of at the time. There's obviously hundreds more, but these are a very good place to start. Also, I played it on acoustic guitar, so there's no excuses. You can still bend strings on an acoustic. It just hurts more, that's all. Anyway, here's my solo, followed by a backing track, so that you can try the solo out yourself. The more adventurous of you may even want to try improvising. Good luck, and I'll see you next month.
Hi, Eric here with this month's acoustic installment. This issue I'm looking at the music of one of my favorite guitarists, Alex Degrassi. The track Short Order is taken from his Deep at Night album and uses the altered tuning commonly known as Dadgad. First you'll hear the tuning notes and then the track. Hope you enjoy it. See you next month.
Hi, this is Richard Stockwright with this month's Classical Guitar. Originally written as a lute song by an unknown composer, Greensleeves is one of the most popular and haunting tunes from the Elizabethan era. Nowadays, it is usually arranged as a guitar solo, but try not to lose sight of the song-like qualities of this piece as you're learning it. Enjoy playing through the music. See you soon. This month's classical guitar feature was brought to you in association with Barnes & Mullins.
Hi, Eric here with the imaginatively titled Naked Ladies and Electric Ragtime. Sounds like a place in Soho where all the GT staff frequent. Anyway, this Michael Chapman tune is in standard tuning with a capo at the 2nd fret. Don't forget to tap your foot on beats 1 and 3 throughout. Here's the tune, hope you enjoy it. See you next month.
Hi, welcome to TaylorMade. This month I've taken a well-known Irish air to demonstrate how we can get a full sound by just playing a few notes. This follows on from the lessons we had a couple of months ago, where we looked at constructing tunes using tenths. This is a different and I think more interesting approach than just playing melody on top of block chords.
Hi, Eric here with another acoustic column. This month, it's the mother of all movie themes, My Heart Will Go On, as performed by Celine Dion. I've arranged the song on the key of E, with a modulation into the key of A flat at the end. Give this one plenty of feeling, boys and girls. It's the classic love song. See you all next month.
Hi, Lee here with this month's main transcription, Angie by the Rolling Stones. That's Angie with a G, incidentally, as opposed to Angie with a J, which you will find elsewhere on this month's GTCD. Here, we've opted for the tempo at which the song settles, and that's a leisurely 70 beats per minute. The main acoustic guitar part can be heard on the left channel, while a supportive part, entering at the bridge section, can be heard on the right-hand side. As usual, you can find an authentic-sounding backing track after the demo. By the way, that's Phil Hilborn playing the piano and string parts. Isn't he good to you, eh? On that backing track, you'll hear a count of 4, plus a bar of 2-4 that accommodates the brief harmonic, and then you carry on playing the intro proper in 4-4. Okay, find yourself a fairly thin plectrum, and why not give the piece a go? It's great fun. Lee Hodgson signing off. Thank you.
Hi, Eric here again with another acoustic installment. This month we're looking at the classic ragtime tune, The Entertainer by Scott Joplin. Most of you will know this is the theme tune to the motion picture The Sting. The arrangement is in standard tuning, and I've arranged the first two sections. The original is a bit longer. Hope you enjoy the tune. See you next month.
Hi, Dave Kay here with the Grammy Award-winning single Change the World, as played by the guitar legend Eric Clapton. The track sounds great with just guitar, so we decided to leave the keyboards off the backing track. Also, it means that you can more easily hear what's going on. So here's the guitar intro, example 1, with the melody, example 2, joining in after 4 bars. After that you have the verse and chorus, examples 3 and 4, with the guitar fills, heard in the verse and chorus, found in examples 5 and 6. Thank you. Here's a backing track with a rhythm guitar so that you can practice the guitar fills.
Hi, Eric here. Happy Christmas. This month we're looking at the traditional Yuletide tune, God Rest You Merry Gentlemen. As I'm wont to do, I've swung the rhythms about a bit and added some interesting chords. Hope it keeps you busy over the holidays. See you in 1999.
Hi, this is Richard Stockwright with this month's Beginning Classical Guitar. Arpeggios occur in one form or another in the music of all eras and are an important aspect of any classical guitarist's technique. As always, practice slowly at first, building up speed over a period of time. Remember, accuracy is more important than speed. Take the time to practice the separate arpeggio exercises. These will help in the performance of the main piece. Honest. Enjoy playing through the music and I'll see you soon. This month's classical guitar feature was brought to you in association with Barnes & Mullins.
Hi, Eric here with another acoustic installment. This month we're looking at the classic Simon and Garfunkel track, Scarborough Fair. Remember, the tune requires a capo at the 7th fret, so be sure to check out the text in the magazine regarding the notation of capo notes. The original tune repeats the verse figure a number of times, and for our version, we've given you 3. Add extra verses as necessary. Here's the tune, hope you enjoy it. See you next month.
This is Martin Taylor, and welcome to TaylorMade. Last month, I showed you a fairly straightforward arrangement of Auld Lang Syne. This month, I'm going to take it a little further, reharmonizing to give it a more jazzy flavour, while still maintaining the melody. Just. With a fairly busy arrangement like this, it's very important that the melody doesn't get lost, so keep this in mind when you're playing the transcription through, and try to keep the melody to the fore. Thank you.
Hi, Eric here with another Unplugged. This month we're continuing our look at classical duets with Invention No. 13 by J.S. Bach. On the left channel, Phil Hilborn's playing guitar part 1, and I appear on the right channel playing guitar part 2. There's a lot of interplay between both parts, and it is quite tricky, so make sure you count carefully throughout. See you next month.
Hi, this is Richard Stockerite with this month's classical guitar. The use of the intervals of thirds and sixths in 18th century guitar music is very common. Fernando Sor made particularly effective use of them, both in his concert pieces and student works. This exercise in thirds and sixths is incredibly inventive and will help improve your knowledge of these intervals and how they lie under the fingers. Enjoy playing through the music. See you soon. This month's classical guitar feature was brought to you in association with Barnes & Mullins.
Hi, Eric here with the second in our series of altar tuning lessons. Here's drop A tuning from low to high. And here's example one. Thank you. And example two. 1, 2, 3, 4. This month we're also looking at drop C tuning. Here are your tuning notes. And here's an idea in drop C. Hope you enjoy working through the material. See you next month.